Requiem Mass. And this particular work focuses on a concept that you will see in the translation, which is listed and which I suggest that you follow. This particular work focuses on a particular concept, and that is an ancient concept which comes back again and again through liturgy from long before the time of Christ. And that is, when we die, we enter into a state of darkness, and from that time forward seek a state of perpetual life. And perpetua comes back again and again, et lux perpetua, and light eternal, perpetual light, may perpetual light shine upon it. May they find the source of that light. And as you can imagine, that fits into so many religions. The concept is consistent with thoughts in so many religions. The Requiem is, although somber, always must be looked upon with a feeling of deliverance, a feeling that these people have passed on, people who have passed on to a new and better life, have received a reward for enduring the pains, for simply making it through this life. And at the time in which the Requiem and the text was developed, you have to consider the fact that life was a true trial. It is not like our wonderful lives today. Life was truly a trial that they had to pass through. And so this seeking this perpetual life was a concept that was a glorious concept to them. Many of the melodies are very chant-like and go back to fragments of the original Requiem melodies which we hear in antiquity in Gregorian chant. The Fauré Requiem was written in essentially this instrumentation initially, and then the instrumentation was expanded. We have gone back to the original instrumentation and an original version which has just been published before I record.
Thank you. star.